Anybody stop over the camera who can give me settings just by giving a situation? Wow, awesome. Okay, all three of you put your hands up, please, on shift. apart from that, I will talk about lighting. Lighting techniques as in 1-point lighting, 2-point lighting, 3-point lighting, and top lighting. What does that do? Tell me. I think one of you will have to get up and say, I'm getting bored. Seeing your people's faces, you all are looking very, very, that you all are not understanding.
1-point light is one source of light, and 2-point is two sources of light, and right. 3 is three sources of light.
But what is the difference between all three of them?
1-point light, you only have one source of light. So you will place that, like there are many types of light which you can not do with the 1-point light.
Right.
So it is slit lighting, one is butterfly, which right. will be face, like the lights will be put in front of the subject. So that there is a butterfly shape under the nose.
Hmm. In this chair. Right. So because what happens with that, the light is not spread evenly. Today when the more number of lights you use, the more perfect your subject can be lighted. Supposingly if you have a top light, okay, that will light your hair up. So you'll get a silver lining on top of your hair. You have a backlight, it will give outlines of your body, it will give highlights of your body when you have a backlight behind you. Okay? When you have two-sided light, so if this side shadow is coming, this side shadow is coming, both is deinterlacing between itself and is creating a no shadow zone. So that a 4-point light is one of the perfect lightings that we understand in studio photography. Whereas for outdoor, I would recommend that even a single flash could do it. Or a single Godox, if you all have heard of this brand called Godox flashes, they are the best in the market as of now. You know what is apertures and what is the depth of field and apertures got to do with?
Yes.
What is the F numbers? The higher the F number, the lower the light that will come in.
Yes.
What's the meaning of that?
That means the window is, we are regulating the amount of light. The more the window is open, the
more the light will come in.
Yes.
Right? So. That is the reason F numbers is called usually the depth of field in photography. So what we do is, if we want to shoot a human subject, we will maybe give it an aperture of 5.6 or 6.3. If it's a group, we will give it an aperture of 8.1. Why? Because we want all clears. Now this is a normal speed light. A normal flash that you'll put on top of your camera. Now supposedly, I just flash in, okay? You're not coming to know what's happening. But the camera captures this light. Right? Supposing I fire this on me, okay? You saw that? So the camera is capturing that light that is coming on me. So what happens is when a flash is out here and you are shooting me from there maybe. This is usually done with a trigger, a use of a trigger. That is attached to the camera. And when you click from there, the trigger fires a flash on wherever you are standing. So whichever side of light you want to give. Usually in your DSLRs, you will have your on-camera flash. But if you see any professional camera, you will not ever have a flash on top of the camera. The reason being is that there are multiple equipments that have to be put in. Like maybe an LED screen, or you can say a hot shoe, or whatever needs to be put on top. So that's the reason. There are sometimes even mics attached, boom mics attached. So at that point of time, where will you put the flash? So this is what you do, you put a trigger. Trigger के ऊपर भी एक horseshoe रहता है, through which you put your trigger. Over the horseshoe you put your trigger or your mic, whatever you desire to put. Somebody, anyone volunteering from ladies? I want you to click a picture. Both of you will click the same picture. So it is not that you are being clicked. I want you to click a subject's picture. So I just want you to come up with your phone and click a picture. That's it. One of you, come on. Anybody? But one lady, yeah, come on. What's your name?
Ratnani.
And what's your good name, lady?
Jessica.
Please, come on. Okay. Now. if supposedly you will have to click this umbrella, both of you, okay? One person turns around while the first person is clicking, and then the second person clicks. The fourth.
Start.
Release first. Click it in however you feel it will be creative or it will be different. Whatever is your idea. Now supposedly you would take a selfie. You would have pouted, you would have done this, that. You would have done that.
Yeah.
Now you turn around. One only, one picture. That's it. Okay, both of you guys show your pictures.
I can't do the same thing with them, so it will be
clear. Right. See, now there's a difference between boys and girls. Clear? I told both of them the same instruction. I told both of them to click the same thing. Right? One is click a full umbrella, one is click a half umbrella. Now I need to tell the reason why have you done this. I mean, what have you seen? Why did you click a half umbrella?
Initially, I actually clicked like the full umbrella.
Right.
But then after you said that I have to be a little creative, I thought everybody will click the full umbrella, so
right.
I went with half.
Now you can see this picture. There's a blackout behind. That's the reason I told them to click this picture, because after all of you all being here also, only the umbrella is there. It's a blackout background. Well, can you see anything else in the frame? Now, if today if you convert this into a monochrome image or a black and white,
yeah.
Please have your seat. Thank you so much. Can we have a round of applause for them? Now, that's the difference. This is the same thing what I'm trying to tell you, that the brighter the light, the more things will go out. That is the reason you all have seen most of the studios. Has anybody seen a film set or a studio set? Some of you all might have, or some of you all might have seen it on TV, the behind the scenes or something when they shoot. Usually the studio setup is in a black background. There is no natural light. Supposing this light is coming in the studio, it will not be there. Why? Because the studio light is controlled from all sides. I will decide how much light has to be on this side, how much light has to be on that side, to give perfect lighting to the model. Supposingly I want only a half lit model, means this side should be blackout. I will not on this side light. Or I'll not on the headlight. Why? Because that is a point of lighting that we give to our subjects. Now, they clicked the picture of this umbrella, it was bright, so all of you went black. This similar situation happens outdoor when the sun is there, what I was talking about. That when the sunlight is there, you always go black in front of the frame. So that's the reason we use an external or an artificial light called a flash. So what happens with that is basically, what you do is under expose your background. So this subject is going to go fully blackout. Right? But what happens with the flash? In daytime, I'm talking about. What will happen? Your flash will light your subject. आप सबने सेकेंड ईयर में हो तो आप सबने कुछ ना कुछ सोचा होगा कि ये करियर करना है वो करियर करना है. यू आर वन कैटिंग अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर करियर आज में प्लीज. राइट. ओके. It's a brilliant question, because I think your guys more have gone on to more of editing rather than photography. The essence is somewhere lost of photography itself. So I am a graphic designer, a professional graphic designer from 10 years. I have done my course in Arena Multimedia. Okay. Now I'll tell you how it works. Today if you know editing, you are a better photographer. Why? Why? Because you can highlight or cover up your mistakes in it. Otherwise you will not be able to cover up. Aapne camera se picture liya, abhi you can sit, you can be sit. I'll answer your question. you can, supposedly, you have a very dark lit subject. Now you want to lighten it up, or you have got an overexposed subject. Pure face pe white aa gaya hai, shirt to pura blown out ho gaya because he was wearing a white shirt. Aur flash mara, to wo shirt ke to kuch bhi dhajja ud gaya. Right? So there is something called a highlight tool in Lightroom, which you just brush it over that shirt. So you can reduce the lightings. Usually retouchers or technical editors do these kind of jobs. Now, I'll give you a very creative example of a shot in photography. Supposingly, I have a tripod mounted out here. Okay, I'm standing out here, I click a frame. I stand out here, I click a frame. I stand out here, I click a frame. I stand like this 5 places and I click a frame on the tripod if the camera is mounted. These 5 shots in one step can be merged into one picture. I'll be standing on 5 places of the stage in one picture. And that's just a click in Photoshop. There's a mode called HDR Basics, which you all, I don't know whether you all have heard about it or not. But in a one click, or just by erasing simply a layer out of that zone, you have 5 people standing. So that becomes creative. When your editing is involved, that becomes creative.
So, light stops
ke bare mein kya? So basically, light stops is for deciding your aperture and the lighting mode of your camera. Okay. Are you all familiar with a DSLR first of all?
Yes.
Everybody is familiar with a DSLR,
yes.
Right? How many of you all shoot on automatic mode? Phone mein? Phone mein tum log khichte ho? To phone mein bhi aajkal Vivo mein and this and that, all these have pro modes. In which you have to set the aperture, the ISO, etc. Right? Why are they removing these pro modes? What is it for? It is so that you can get the right exposure of your frame. Right? Today, supposingly I will say that agar background mein sunlight hai, 12 o'clock in the noon, sunlight is right on top of your head. You have to shoot. So I guess whether it be your phone, whether it be your DSLR, any of that sort of equipment, you will have a blackout. Your faces will not have any color on it. You will only be able to see an overexposed background. That too a white flat background hoga. Barabar. So because of that, we are using these pro modes. Now I want to teach you all basically ke not only about DSLR or not only about photography, but in general life. Aaj koi party mein jaate, we go to a club. Yaar, ambient bahut acha hai. We want to capture it, but wo sahi lighting nahi aata hai. Reason being is that we are not using the pro modes for it. Today, don't use a DSLR, use a phone, use a basic phone, use, try to understand what is ISO, what is aperture and what is the shutter speed of it. All of you all use flashes, you all know what flashes are. So there are two things in this, there are two types of lights, one is a natural light and one is a strobe light, if you all know. A strobe is a flash and a natural light is something like the sun or the ambient. A natural light usually sets the mood of the subject. Can anyone get up from you? Yeah. Now, if I'm standing here, okay?
Yes.
And you go back and see in the frame of the camera what is coming. And I want you to tell everybody what is coming. Am I a little blackish? Thoda light, right? Okay. But now, I'll just keep this mic here.
If I go back to this quarter eyes, okay, you will see it brightening up a little bit, right? That is why these lights are there. Now, what are these lights doing? Basically, if you go to see, what's the difference of this? Okay, can anyone tell me what's the difference of this light without an umbrella? Why are we using an umbrella? Raise your hands. Too many chorus voices.
It diffuses the light.
What do you mean by diffusing the light?
Soft shadows. It spreads the light.
Right. So it does not create hard shadows indirectly. Right. Means it's softening the shadows. It does not create shadows. It does not soften, but it does not create shadows. If you are having a distance of about 5 feet from the light, it will not let you create a shadow behind. So that is the reason. what we are facing today. When I passed out Udaan School of Photography around 7 years back, that time equipment didn't have technology, what we have right now. Any of you all, if you understand what technology is running, if you go to see the Facebook 360 degrees,
yes.
Right? Facebook has created 360 degrees, but yet our cameras don't have any technology. I mean, even if you go for a Nikon D850, the highest end camera, or a Canon Mark IV, none of them still have the 360 degree technology. For that, you know how much the camera comes? It's only a 9,000 rupees camera, your 360 degree content. So technology is taking you all day by day up and above. आपको टेक्सटबुक्स में बोला गया होगा डोंट यूज आईएसओ नॉइज बढ़ता है सब्जेक्ट का लो लाइट्स में और इवन इफ यू ऑल हैव विटनेस्ड इट मे बी वेरेवर और हाउएवर मोबाइल में आता है पिक्सल्स आता है यू विल गो टू अ क्लब और यू विल गो एंड शूट इन वन स्मॉल लाइट ऑफ अ रूम नॉइज ग्रीन्स रेनबो इफेक्ट आएगा फोन में भी आएगा कैम में भी आएगा दोनों में आएगा तो व्हाट डू यू डू नाउ इफ यू वांट You want an ambient light also, you want no noise to come also, what will you do? Very simple, aaj kal tum log kya karte ho, ek filter laga lete ho, khatam baat ho gayi. Ya to shayad se grains nikal loge Photoshop aur Lightroom mein. You all use Photoshop Lightroom, any of you all? So you all will be knowing what I'm talking about, right? Color temperatures, this, that, etc. Whatever it is there. Compositions. That is the main thing I guess you all are into now. I've seen a lot of creative photographers coming out from colleges, 11, 12, 14, winning national awards. Why? Because they have meaning in their photography. What is the meaning of photography? Creating a concept. Even if you take a picture of just this chair, if you create a story around it, this chair is lying here, it's isolated, there's nobody sitting on the chair. It shows the emptiness of the room. So that's a single concept. So when you conceptualize your shoot, that's the time when you get, the space for it, the concept for it, and that is the reason that you get known for it.
Walk with lights, perspective, lights and lights.
Right. Okay. So first of all, if your guys shoot in RAW, right?
Yeah.
Now in a camera, if you're shooting in RAW. And even if you have put it on a monochrome mode, still when you open it in Lightroom, the image will be in color. Because it's a raw image, it's an uncompressed image, you can do multiple things with it. So even if you have shot it in monochrome, it will be in a color zone when you open it in Lightroom. Have anyone of your witnesses shooting in RAW? You know what is RAW? Yes. Let's know what is a RAW file.
Yes.
It's usually a 20-30 MB uncompressed file of your camera.
Yes.
Through which you can do anything and everything to the image later on. You don't need to set your camera on portrait mode. You don't need to do the temperature zoning, basically whether it's more yellowish or bluish, the Kelvin settings that is called. You don't need to do all that if you're doing it on RAW because all those options are there in Lightroom to do it on later on. So what happens in black and white images in this perspective, we have a color zone shading in the Lightroom panel. It's called HLS, Hue, Saturation, Luminance. And it's there for every color. Now if you just convert your image to a black and white, now you want the face to be more brighter and the hair to be more blacker or whatever, you want a proper black and white contrast for monochrome. So you will just, shift the red bar and the orange bar towards the whitish zone. That will remove the grayish from your image and it will make a more whitish perspective. And there's something called the blacks. You just press your Alt key down and you push it in. So you will see that your image is going blacker and sharper. And just put down the clarity bar. All this is technically, those guys who know Lightroom will understand what I'm talking about. Right. Everybody is interested somewhere or the other to get into the film line. Either into PR, either into marketing, either into social media, digital marketing. Trust me, everything is connected. Goal, ghoom ke bhai pe aa jaoge. Because if you are into marketing, you will tell the photographer what kind of concepts you want to shoot. If you are into social media marketing, you will tell the videographer, I want to make such a concept video, you work this out for me. Okay? Then if you are into PR, you are writing for magazines, so you need a perfect shot that what you are going to write a story about. So everywhere your media line is linked to cameras, because without, what is a camera? It's media. Indirectly, it's a visual media, right? So that's the way you are going to get linked to it sooner or later in life, maybe 5 years down the line or whatever. But photography will be an important subject. And at that time, if you know your basics, okay, मुझे ऐसा टाइप का शूट चाहिए, आप कौन से भी लाइन में हो आप उसमें बनोगे, बिकॉज यू आर वर्ड ऑफ मिस मानी, आई होप यू आर वर्ड ऑफ पॉप एक्सो, दीज आर सम ऑफ द वायरल ब्रांड्स. व्हाट आर दे? आर दे फोटोग्राफर्स और वीडियोग्राफर्स? दे आर कंटेंट पीपल, दे आर होल्डिंग कंटेंट इन देयर हैंड, दे आर राइटिंग ब्लॉग्स. हाउ विल दे राइट ब्लॉग्स इफ दे डोंट हैव पिक्चर्स टू शो? Supposingly, if you are writing a blog, a travel blog, example, you want to show Singapore, or you want to show Malaysia, you want to show the Gili Islands. If you don't have a picture, do you think a person is going to read an entire 4-page article without seeing a picture of that place? No, I don't think so. So that is why photography is important. So you all need to understand the essence of the importance of photography in any field. Today, maybe your generation is taking it to clicking pictures in a phone. Brilliant, because I believe that there will be a time, maybe 5 years down the line, where DSLRs will be of no use. Phone will have the technology. Your phones will have it. Today, an S8, 9 or an S8 Plus or an iPhone 10, if you see, they have bloody better megapixel cameras than my bloody 5D Mark 3s or Mark 4s. They have a better megapixel, I'm not denying the fact. But the point is, what they don't have is the lightning. You cannot attach a trigger to it. You cannot do external lighting to it. So what happens? The default goes that then DSLR. So this is what the generation is going into now.